On November 8, 2016, Narendra Modi, the Prime Minister of India, announced the demonetization of high-value currency notes. The government attempted to tackle, in a single stroke, three main issues plaguing the economy: a parallel economy, counterfeit currency, and terror financing. It was anticipated that 20 to 30% of the currency notes would not make it back to the system. But to everyone's horror, over 95% of money came back. It was enough for Modi critics to call demonetization a monumental failure. The criticism was regardless of the fact that number of direct tax returns filed, number of persons filing returns, and number of taxpayers all registered multifold increase, and digital transactions in India grew by over 3,000%. It has been almost 5 years now. The ones who probably deposited black money at that time had forgotten the past, but the government hasn't. And there is a big shockwave about to hit India soon. Hi and welcome to TFI English, the national socio-political analysis arm of the TFI Media Group. I am your host, Diksha Verma, and in this video, I will tell you about how the aftershocks of demonetization are about to hit India again, and the ones who did nasty business in 2016 will be made to pay. Let's begin. The Reserve Bank of India on Tuesday wrote to all banks and directed them to store the CCTV footage belonging to the period of November 8 to November 30, 2016 in a careful manner and told them to not destroy the recordings. After 5 years of demonetization, many would have grown the opinion that all is well, and the corrupt particularly would be relaxing, thinking that the horrifying days for them are now over. However, the Modi government's appetite to surprise Indians has not decreased a tad bit. And now, a potential mass investigation might be launched into the activities of corrupt individuals and black money holders. It is possible that the government and the investigating agencies might begin making use of CCTV recordings from November and December of 2016 to identify black money holders and thereafter initiate stringent action against them. The corrupt always seem to require a reminder that their days of glory are limited, and a message in that direction seems to be approaching fast. On the basis of various inputs, the investigative agencies had started probing matters relating to the illegal accumulation of new currency notes in the aftermath of demonetization. In order to facilitate such investigations, the RBI has asked the banks not to destroy the CCTV recordings of the period of demonetization till further orders. In its order issued on Tuesday, the RBI said, "Keeping in view the investigations pending with law enforcement agencies, proceedings pending at various courts, you are advised to preserve the CCTV recordings of operations at bank branches and currency chests for the period from November 8, 2016 to December 30, 2016 in a proper way till further orders." This order comes as a reminder to banks. In a similar order issued in December 2016 itself, RBI had directed all banks to ensure that they do not destroy CCTV footages pertaining to the demonetization period at any cost. As per RBI's Mint Street memo of August 2017, currency notes of demonetization of Rs. 1000 and Rs. 500 valued at Rs. 15.4 lakh crore and constituting 86.9% of the value of total notes in circulation were demonetized. Of the rupees 15.41 lakh crore worth rupees 500 and rupees 1000 notes in circulation on November 8, 2016, currency worth rupees 15.31 lakh crore was returned. Demonetization has severely battered the parallel economy which had come into existence in India, while also inflicting a personal loss on all corrupt individuals in possession of unaccounted cash. Terrorists too were battered, as their industry surviving on the foundation of fake currency fell apart right before their eyes. the horrors of demonetization seem to be lurking at large once again for corrupt black money hoarders. Certainly, Prime Minister Narendra Modi's bold move was supposed to have long-term consequences, which are now appearing to be set in motion. The latest move of the RBI will ensure that whenever need be, all corrupt activities during the period of demonetization can be monitored, and action taken against perpetrators of the same.